birthday to me. Happy birthday to me. Hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 today. Woo! And from the Netherlands, hence the accent. I'm getting ready and I have my coffee. I have some goodies that I really want to play with. And I thought let's kind of get ready together. So I have a fancy dress on. Unfortunately, I'm also wearing the wrong bra because, yeah. I think I should have worn either my purple one or my black one, but that's neither here nor there. We're just going to ignore it. I'll probably wear a scarf later, so you won't see it anyway. But yeah, today I am playing with... What am I playing with? I want to play with the Baroque palette from Colourpop, because I haven't. And I really want to play, hence the dress. And I want to try the foundation that I have here, the EX1 foundation. And shall I give the Natasha Denona base another go? Sure. I think that is a little bit it, guys. I just really want to, I don't know, get ready and such. So, I think I'm going to start how I always start, and that's with brows. Itchy nose, as per usual. I'm going to start with my Guilty Cosmetics Cotton Candy stuff. I have already wetted it. And I'm just basically going to paint it on. I did a video... It's not online yet. Basically a tutorial on how I use this for my sparser brows. I'm trying a different technique today though. I'm also brushing against the hair instead of just with the hair. I do like it. Now that I kind of know my preferred way of using it, I do really like it. So... This is my preferred way of using it. So basically, I painted in the brows first. Why, you may ask? Well, basically, because a spoolie doesn't work for me. Spoolie just doesn't work in my brows, guys. Especially the normal spoolies don't. That's why I loved the... What's it called again? The Benefit... brow gel so much. Not specifically because of the gel, but because of the applicator. So I still have that applicator. Because I did use it a lot, but yeah, then I found Soap Brow and I stopped using the brow gel. So if you don't have that problem, if you just can work gel in your brows with a normal spoolie, then you can just use a normal spoolie with this. But I cannot. So yeah, today is my birthday. As I'm filming this as well, I wanted to film this yesterday. So I kind of had a little bit of time, you know, to edit and upload and all that. But yeah, stuff happened. I was too busy yesterday to film. So I didn't. So it is this morning, the 12th of February. It is currently 10 a.m. Central European time or Amsterdam time. What next? Oh yeah, usually, I don't know, does the Baroque palette have fallout? Because I kind of need to mix foundations, right? Usually I do the rest of my brows now, but I need to mix the foundation and I don't really know the correct... Let's just do eyes first then, because I really don't know how to do everything, and it does not really matter either. Okay, I do want to swatch the palette because I'm very, very curious. So I think we all know it, right? So here she is, very, very pretty, and it's so up my alley, this color story. Let's swatch it. I'm going to go start here, and I'm going to go like that, row by row. I'm going to swatch on a clean bare arm. It has hairs, but yeah. That's what it... Oh no, not a kitty cat. Of course a kitty cat. So, can you see what I'm doing? Yeah. Can I see what I'm doing? I hope so. It's a nice gray. Oh, I can see there what I'm doing. Okay, so this one doesn't swatch the best, but yeah, it's a gray, so I'm not too worried. I need a cloth thingy. It's just such a unique color story. Now, the funny thing is that I have... gotten a lot of comments when I'm wearing blue eyeshadow. I just, there is a specific kind of blue that I, can I, if I watch, if I look there, can you see here? There's a specific kind of blue that I like to use and that I feel is flattering on me. And that is basically a little bit more of the grayer blues. So, for instance, I like a blurple, but I don't like a blue with a purple hint in it. Does that make sense? I don't know. I don't find that flattering on me. Wow. Wow. Oh, okay. So, yeah. They don't swatch the best. You know what they swatch like? They swatch like indie eyeshadows. They also feel like indie eyeshadows. But that's okay. That's not a problem at all, actually. Very pigmented. And drier. That is why they swatch the way they do. But I don't mind that too much. It's just for me. Then I kind of know that I need to work with them a little bit differently. But I don't usually pack on a lot of shadows. Anyway. What do I want to do? Let's start with priming the eyes. I have the Natasha Denona Eye Base here. I have the shade Medium. I don't exactly know why I thought I wanted the shade Medium instead of the shade Light. Maybe it is the fact that I have the ABH foundation, no, concealer, and that one is in Light and it's very, very pale for me. Now, when you look at it, you're like, girl, that's too dark. But when I tap it out, it's actually not that bad. It's not very, very light, but it is kind of my skin tone. And when I'm in summer and I am a little bit more tan, then it's lighter, basically. Does that make sense? The ABH one is so, so light then. And not that I'm very dark, but apparently sometimes I'm darker than I think I am. You know? Or paler than I think I am. Because now, and I have, you will probably be sick of me mentioning the fact that I just found out that I have an olive undertone. But it just makes me, you know, when I went searching in the neutral foundation spectrum, I usually was a light medium. So, perfectly in between, you know. And now with the olive foundations, I need to go lighter. Because this one, for instance, is a light medium. But can you see how dark it is for me? It's also, I feel a little bit too pink almost. And I have another olive foundation, which is, as you can see, a lot more yellow. So I kind of need to, I have the lightest shade here as well. So this is 3.5. This is 1, I believe. Because I thought I can mix it. You know, maybe this is more along the lines of my summer color. And then I can lighten it up a little bit. But looking at the undertones here, this one looks a little bit more yellow. This one looks a little bit more pinkish. So maybe I can mix them to create my perfect shade. And otherwise, maybe I just need to DM them on Instagram and ask. Because the site is not giving me a lot of help. So yeah, I'm making a mess of my palette. As I always do. I don't really want to go... Do I want to go dark and dramatic? You never know with me though, but I kind of want to use this one. So I'm going to. I'm just doing a one colored crease because it has been a while. So yeah, let me get my brushes. And how do I do a one colored crease? Well, basically I need a big fluffy brush, or at least a very, very, not specifically big, but a very fluffy brush. So I can lay down basically a wash of color. So maybe I will start with this one then, which is the, if you are looking for good eye brushes, good value for money, go to Nabla. I have two brush sets. I have the Amethyst and I have the Ruby. I really want to get the nude one as well. So I have all three sets. They are just so, so good. The most expensive one is the Ruby set because it has the most brushes. And that one is, I think, 30 euro. But way cheaper than Sigma, and in my opinion, way better as well. So, yeah. I'm going to go into the shade Lounge. Very, very lightly. Tapping off the brush, and I'm just going to go to town with it. Do I need to go to town today? I don't know. Maybe I will. If I'm feeling very fabulous, I'm just going to strut around. Outside. Take my dog and... I kind of expect this shade to be a little bit patchy. just because of the nature of the shade. So I'm just really tapping off my brush. I'm going in slow and tapping it on my eye. I was going to do a get ready with me and it ends up being more of a tutorial. But yeah, that's basically the way that I am, I think. I don't know, I have a very hard time just, I don't know, chatting about something and just doing my makeup instead of telling you why I'm doing something. But yeah, that's maybe me. Okay, it's nice and dark and dramatic. There's still a little bit of snow and ice laying around. It's not snowing anymore, but there's still a little bit of snow. There's ice on the moats. Is that, isn't the moat around the castle? You get the drift, I hope. So I don't think we can skate on natural ice here in the neighborhood where I live. Not that I, maybe I have even forgotten how to ice skate. It's been so long since I have skated on natural ice. We used to be able to do that every single year. I still have pictures of me and my sister on the natural ice in front of our house. Hell, I remember even one of our dogs. There was, we had ice on the watery bit in front of our house, the moat. I don't know what to call it, guys. I just don't. But it has been, had been snowing as well. And our dog was very enthusiastic and he wanted to get across. So he just jumped on the ice and went. Do you know the scene Bambi where Bambi is on the ice? Well, basically that happened. So he was like, what's happening here? He kind of liked it being on the ice though. So yeah, we were truly every year we could ice skate on natural ice. And it has been so long since I was able to. Well, theoretically I could this year maybe. But again, I don't even know if I still know how to ice skate. I think so, because I think that if you know how to, I don't think you will forget. Just like riding a bike, you know. Even if I haven't done that in years, it's getting a bit patchy. But that's, again, I think the nature of the shadow. And maybe the eye base too. Could be. It's almost, now looking at what is happening here, especially on this eye, it's almost, it reminds me of the Natasha, the ABH eyeshadow formula. Where the darker shades are almost oily on me. They kind of have a sheen to them. It's not my preferred formula, but maybe it's a combination of the shade and the base. I don't know. Very dark and dramatic. Yes, I know. Like me. Do I want to blend it out? Not. Yeah, I kind of do, but I think I need a face powder for that. So let me get the powder I usually use. It's just a face powder. You can use any face powder that you like. I just want the edge a little bit more blended, but I don't want to use one of the grays because I feel like this is too brown of a shade for me to use the grays to blend it out. Yes? Yes. Is there anything that I want to chat about today? I actually don't know. I don't know. Oh yeah, before I forget, see? I almost forgot something pretty important. There's not going to be a Let's Talk Makeup today, obviously, because this is the video that's going to go up today. What happened was that, well, basically Nomad happened. I kind of, it's not their fault. It's not their fault at all, but I forgot the day. That's basically it. That's what happened. I don't know, sometimes the days just pass me by. You know, in the last few weeks, I had the feeling that it was I don't know, Monday when it was Saturday and vice versa. So it was just very, very weird. The experience was very weird. So usually I film my... Is there still black on this? Probably. Usually I film my Let's Talk Makeup on either Tuesday or Wednesday. And this week I failed to do that. So that's what happened. And then I was like, well, maybe I will film it, if I can film it on Wednesday, it's still early enough, you know, and I have time to edit everything. But yeah, it didn't happen. So there's no Let's Talk Makeup today, obviously. And you're getting this instead. That's, yeah. That's the way it's going to be. Can I put you a little bit higher in light? Oh, yeah, there I am. That's so nice. Do I want the blue? Sure. Why not? So, I'm grabbing a brush that's a little bit denser. And I'm going to go into the shade Stunner. I'm too lazy to hold up the palette today. Let's go in that shade. Because while I like the tone of the brown that I worked with, I don't really like how it is applying. This is a bit better. So apparently we're going for the dark dramatic look today. I'm apparently making a mess of it as well. So it's almost like I have forgotten how to do makeup, really. I'm so glad I can clean everything up because I feel like I'm really, really making a mess. What else do I want to chat about? Shall I go to the shade Bebe, which is the... What matte is that? This one, I believe? This one? Is that... Or is that too light, maybe? Yeah, I don't know. Well, let's just go there, because I can. Just going to put that here in the inner part and maybe blend over a little bit. I don't think that this is basically your I'm in a subtle mood palette. This is a pretty dark and dramatic palette, isn't it? I don't like the way that brown is looking though. So I'm just going to go back to that darker blue. It almost doesn't want to stick, and I don't know if it is the base or the shade. The only time I had this problem with ColourPop eyeshadows was in the Just My Luck, that green palette. That very nice, what was it, a dark olive that was in there. It just did not want to work for me. Well, it did, but it was very, very frustrating. So that was one of the reasons that I gave that palette away, because it was just too frustrating for me to work with. You know, I want makeup to be fun too. And this brown almost gives me the same vibe. And again, the shades almost look a little bit oily on me. Or there's a sheen, but they're not satins. And that is not my preferred formula, but that's okay. Shall I grab the black? Sure, why not? Let's grab the black called Grand with those micro sparkles in it. Let's just go there. Oh, that is cool though. Oh, and now I'm very, very happy. You see what's happening? Very happy that I didn't do my face first. I'm just... You know, the best part is, though, if I don't like it, I can always wash it off. I actually don't mind ColourPop's sequence formula, because a lot of the time, those shades are very loose, and you get a lot of pigment. So they're very pigmented shadows. The downside is they are also fallout heavy, as you can probably see. And if I am able to choose, I would rather have these, you know, those sequin shades, than the pressed glitters. Because, yeah. Okay, let's go to a small brush and put stuff in the crease. Sure, I have one from Sigma. This is the Precision Firm Blender. I'm picking up a little bit of the shade Grand and I'm just putting it in the crease. Let's go to a sparkly crease today. Take a little bit of the shade Stunner, that dark blue, and just put it on the edge to make that edge a little bit more blended than just packed on. I think I'm failing, but that's okay. This is not going the way that I want it at all. I don't mind a darker look at all, but sometimes enough is enough. So let's wipe stuff away a little bit. And start over. A tiny bit at least. Can I salvage this? Let's see. I'm just going to try. I'm just filling in the gaps with the shade Bebe. Yeah, something like that. Let's see if I can kind of clean up underneath my eye a little bit with some water. That actually was very, very easy. I don't have any. It's just a microfiber cloth and a tiny bit of water. That is what happened. I think this is it for the mats so far. Yeah, I think so. I think it's time for the shimmer. What's the shimmer I want to use? I think I want to use the shade Noble. I'm just going to use it as is. I'm going to spray it. I don't feel like putting on glitter primer. I think it's actually sad that there's not a gray blue in here. But maybe... Oh, this plays very, very well. It's actually dry. It plays very well with the black. This is what I like. I'm going to spray because I'm curious to see what it does. Oh yeah, I'm glad that it is picking up a little bit more of that. The shade that's underneath that black, basically. Didn't I just clean up underneath my eye? I did, didn't I? My camera stopped recording because I was at the half hour mark and I thought, let me just finish off the eyes. I did not do anything extra. The only thing I did is I added the shade Noble here on my lower lash line and I added a purple pencil from Kiko. Long lasting pencil in the shade 13, which is a deep purple, because I thought it would kind of complement everything. And yeah, that's it. And I put on dramatic falsies because I'm dramatic today. Apparently. So I think it's foundation time. I'm actually quite curious. Let's start with a little bit of... See if I can kind of correct the colors a little bit. With my color corrector from Revolution in the peach. It's just, what is it? Conceal and define, but then in the peach. I also, where's my brush? I know I should wash my brushes, but yeah. Other things are more fun, you know? I'm just basically tapping this in. Oh yeah, and in case you're new, because I know I have some new people, I'm also an overthinker. So now that I have found out that I have an olive undertone, I feel like I need to go through my wardrobe again. Has anything changed? No. Beside the fact that I finally have the correct foundation shade, or at least I hope so. So yeah, and then I know that there are different color spectrums. I think that if I have matched myself correctly, I'm a warm olive. What was it again? Delicate. So then I'm apparently delicate, at least in one part of my life. But yeah, I also know that at least one of you is kind of into the color theory thing. Please help me and correct me if I'm wrong. But yeah, I'm going to mix the two foundation shades. Let me, for funsies, swatch them both first. So let me... Okay, so that's one. Yeah, it's a thicker foundation. Oh, maybe it's not that light then. And then the other one. Oh, yeah, that's pretty dark. So let's just pick the pinky. This is shade 3.5. And then here is shade 1. Oh, that's very light. So this, I feel, is almost too orange. This is too light, but I can mix them. That's what I do with my Catrice foundation as well. So I think more of the... let's just try. I did not prime the face, but that's okay. I have... What do I have? Let's do... I have way too much, but I need to kind of find the way that I need to mix it. Let's get a cotton bud. I have one.
This is one pump of the lightest one, so let me move that to the side. Yes, and let's, I don't know, grab a tiny bit of the darker one and mix.
I know the ratio of the Catrice foundation. It is 3/4 to 1/4, I believe. Let's see this. I think it's okay. maybe it's still too light, but probably if I have everything on, it's okay. I'm trying to match it to my neck, but I don't know. I feel like, let's just mix. I feel like it is too pink. But mixing foundations is kind of trial and error. However, I feel like that shade 3.5, the darkest one that I was basically matched to, is too pink for me. So it's more along the lines of, what did they say, the cool. You know what I find weird? When I look at this, I find it warm. When I look at this, I find it cool. But it's the other way around, if I'm not mistaken. And that throws me off sometimes so much. That is why I usually talk about pink and yellow, because yeah, I also think it depends on who you're asking. I feel my neck is more yellow than my face. Am I correct in that? Now the foundation matches me outside, because that for me is usually the... I think I'm going to message them on Instagram to ask for help, because on their site, I need to mix again. On their site, they say that they are for the warm olive spectrum or something like that. But I know that you have cool olive, you have warm olive, and you have neutral olive. I don't know. I feel like when I mix the Catrice foundation, so basically the yellow olive, I feel that that fits me better. But that's okay. You know, this is a journey for me too. So I'm just trying stuff. So you don't have to. Or do. Oh, that looks kind of like a little bit better. What did I do? I think I mixed a little bit more of the darker one in or something. I don't know what I did. But this looks a little bit better. No. Yeah, I can see. I can see it. It's just a... I think it's too pink almost for me. It looks a little bit better. I don't know what I did though. Exactly. Which is handy, right? Not really. But that's okay. Let's put it over here as well. I will clean it up a little. When I brush it through, I basically brush out the foundation a little bit more. I also ordered the Fenty because it was 30% off. At least the shade that I wanted, which is light olive. 145 I ordered. So, and I don't know, something happened with my payment. So the order was cancelled, which was kind of weird, because I wanted to get the concealer as well. It almost appears to be more yellow right now, but still I feel my neck is more yellow than my face. So what I thought was the case is definitely the case. This particular, at least the shade 3.5 is too pink for me. Oh yeah, that is also what I wanted to say. You see here that bareness, in not too long of a time it's going to get covered up. Because that was also what I was what I was supposed to do today, is get a tattoo. I was supposed to be in the tattoo artist now. But yeah, unfortunately with the whole lockdown that we're in, it's not happening today, which is so sad. Because, yeah, you know how we write the day, which is, let's face it, the only correct date. You know, we write the day, then the month, and then the year. It's the only way to go, people. So, I'm kidding, obviously. But also, I'm kind of not. But I'm allowed to, because it's my channel. however, when you then kind of... write out the day as we would write it, it's 12/2/2021. So that's kind of a special day, you know? So, yeah, I was supposed to get finally my bumblebee tattoo on my birthday. I'm turning 45 today, and the date is kind of special as well. But I remember distinctly when we made the appointment, it was like, well, let's kind of hope we can then. I look like a ghostie. I'm kind of looking in the monitor and it looks okay. When I look in the mirror, I can see that my neck is more yellow than my face. But I need to look in natural light first, I think. So I'm just going to go with it. I'm going to do brows now. So I'm basically just brushing the foundation out a bit. I also want this underneath my eye. I do like the consistency of the foundation though. It's a bit of a thicker foundation, but I don't feel like I really need to set it. I like it. If I can get my correct shade. You know, I don't mind mixing. I don't mind. But this needs to be more yellow. So if I have this, maybe I need the shade 3 then. Because looking at the swatches that I could find online, the shade 3 was more yellow than this. You know, and if I then have to lighten it up, I don't mind that. I don't mind that at all. But yeah, let's get me the correct shade first. What was I saying again? Oh yeah, the bumblebee tattoo. So yeah, basically it's going to go here. So I have a tattoo here as well. It's going to go above that. So the butt is going to be around here. And then it's going to be basically here. So that's going to be an adjustment, I think. Yeah. I hope I can get it soon. Oh yeah, the olive part. Well, I've been thinking about that. And maybe it is just the fact that I do have some Asian blood somewhere. Not a lot though, but still a little. Because my part of my family came from Indonesia. So maybe that's where the oliveness comes from. I don't know. I want my Nabla lip viper because I forgot. So yeah, it's a whole journey now. And it does make sense though, because one of you asked how I knew. Basically I knew because one of you told me. And then I was like, I have been looking. When I found Alex, I think her last name, I know her last name, but I don't really know how to pronounce it. I think it's Anil. I will link her channel down below. I found her, and she is fair to light, also olive, very, very olive. And I also believe that she is a yellow olive. Yes, because she has yellow overtones. And when I found her, I was like, a lot of the things that she says on foundations pulling pink on her, I was like, yeah, I have that as well. But then when I went on looking further, there were other things that were kind of contradictive to that. You know, for instance, I also found someone saying that olive people don't blush. Because red and green kind of cancel each other out. And I agree that red and green cancel each other out. But I have a lot of redness in my face. And still I'm an olive undertone, as I know now. How could I be sure? Because olive foundation looks good on me. It's also how I found out I have ADHD. Because Ritalin worked. But yeah, so, you know, The biggest thing for me is when I look at a lot of foundations, they are too pink or too yellow. And I was always matched way too yellow. Do I need to set it? I don't feel like I need to set it though. So I actually don't really want to. Let's whack on some stuff. What do I want to whack on? Let's start with bronzer. Shall I start with this one? Sure, my Kiko. There was a period in time where I really wanted a foundation more pink because I felt it was prettier on me, and it was on camera. And then when I went outside, I had a pink head, which is not really sexy. It was also in summer, and the funny thing is that when I am in winter, I've said this before, when I'm in winter I get more pink, and when I'm in summer I get more yellow. That's not correct though, that's what I know now, but that is what it looked like, because when I had a neutral foundation, in winter I needed it to be, I want to say cooler, but that's not really it. More cold. And I need to explain that. When I look at my neck right now, it looks yellowy, but harsh yellow. There are warm yellows and then there are cold yellows. For instance, I have one in the... Let me grab it. Maybe that will make more sense then. The Lunar New Year palette from BH Cosmetics. This shade, it's actually a green. But it is a very yellowy, almost neon-y, harsh green. Does that make any sense at all? So this is the warmer one, which is a more mustard, and it has a little bit more orange in it. And this is just a colder one. That is what I mean when I found when I'm like, I kind of have a hard time differentiating between the warm and the cold, because especially when I tried to match my neck to my face and I went to the yellow spectrum, this looked more harsh even. It was just, it's sometimes very, very difficult for me to explain. There's a certain, when I see a warm color, the feeling that I get from a warm color is round. Do I make any sense at all? When I see a true cold color, it is more, let's say, square. It's not round. It's not that warm, that feeling, you know. It's more, I don't know, that, yeah. I don't really know how to explain, but yeah, basically that. So then my neck was that, and my face, because of a lot of redness, I was a little bit thrown off. So yeah. So yeah, and then the Fenty stick was also a thing, because I have the Fenty stick in amber, which is apparently kind of the universal contour shade, at least if you are light skinned. On me, it goes gray purple. It looks like I have been hit in the face, literally. And I have been using that for quite some time. I only have yay much left. And now I'm like, yeah, but it's just truly not the correct. And I was actually talking to my friend Liora. I will leave her channel down below as well. She is a working makeup artist. And I was talking to her about, she said shade matching through internet and pictures and all that is almost impossible. And I agree with her. So I was basically talking to her about the theory behind it a little bit more, because I know that if I want to contour, I kind of need a cooler shade. But when I look here, it's not really gray because of the coloring that I have. So I was kind of looking at Makeup Revolution, because Makeup Revolution is affordable and has a lot of olive shades as well. Then I was like, maybe I can kind of try and see if I can match my perfect bronzer shade and my perfect contour shade from there, and then I can search further, you know. So I was talking to her about it. I said, am I correct in the fact that I'm grabbing the shade Wisp from Colourpop? Am I correct in the fact that if I want an olive contour, or if I want to contour my face and bronze my face, I kind of need to be in the olive spectrum? But then basically contour the cool olive, and then for the bronzing maybe more of a warmer olive? Theoretically, we kind of agreed that theoretically that is the theory. If it is that way in real life, I don't know. But I think I'm going to try it. So I think I'm just going to order a few concealer shades from Makeup Revolution, because the shade 5.7 is almost spot on for me. It's just such a good shade on me. Unfortunately, I don't really like their other foundations. So the one that I have is the Revolution Pro CC Cream that I really like. But yeah, I don't like the Conceal and Define foundation. The X foundation was... Do I still have that one? It was okay, actually. Yeah, I do still have that one. It's actually not a bad foundation. And a lot of neutral foundations pulled to pink on me. So I can mix my... there are some foundations in the drugstore that I have. For instance, the new Catrice one has a warm olive. It's too dark for me, but I can very nicely mix it with neutral sand to get my perfect color. I also have the Essence Pretty Natural in 70, which is warm cashew, which is not green enough, but I can mix in a little bit of green because of I have a green concealer, you know. So as long as it is close, the HD foundation from Catrice, the shade Hazelnut Beige, has a hint of green in it. A hint. So maybe that's also why I prefer... Oh, I'm itchy. Why I preferred that one. I'm rambling. Am I not? Yes, I am. What do I want for blush? I think that's pretty. So let's go to this one from Colourpop. It is a Super Shock in the shade Cherryo. Yes, I need to say it like that. Cheerio. I do. And I apply it with a brush, because otherwise it gets patchy. So I swirl my brush in. And then basically tap on my hand a little. And that was also, every time I would hold up my, oh, you can see the difference, or at least I can. I can really see that my hand is green compared to my head. Can you see that? It's a little bit darker than my neck, but still the same ballpark. So yeah, but it did not matter that every time my hand was too, oh, it's a very, I'm apparently very blushy today as well, was always too harsh compared to my head. And yeah, I don't know why I'm doing this, but apparently we're doing this. I don't know if I like this though. I think I have way too much blush on. So let's tap over it with the sponge. But that's also something that I kind of need to look at now. My blushes, for instance, because the tones that I have, some look good on, I don't know, a neutral foundation. So basically a more pinker foundation. But now that I am wearing foundations with a green hint in it, I have noticed that some blushes just don't look that pretty on me. So yeah, that's the thing. So it is not just the foundation that I need to check. It's everything, which is kind of frustrating and also exciting at the same time. But it's a pretty learning curve. Let's grab some freckles. I actually think this is almost it, guys. Yeah, I think this is it. Do I want a lippy? What would go good with this? Ow. I have a big muscle ache. This? Let's see. Apparently, I kind of failed to know how to do lipstick as well. You know what? We're going to run with it. So yeah, here's the end result. This is how I'm going to look today. Well, almost. Wait. Cat hair. This is how I'm going to look today. Yes. So now you don't see my mean old neck and the bra straps. This is it, guys. This is how I'm going to spend my day, looking like this, fancy and dramatic, as per usual. Thank you so much for watching. And yeah, I think that's it. If you want to accompany me on my olive journey, make sure that you have hit the subscribe button. Share me with your friends if you think that they can benefit from my channel. If you know any other green people, just send them my way. If you are pink, you're welcome here as well. I'm not judging. Spread me around like fungus. That's not always green, is it though? Never mind. Yes, that is it. Thank you so much for watching. I am going to go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there's a link to join in the description box. And if you want to become a member but you don't want your name on the screen, let me know on Instagram. And I will not put your name on the screen, because if you don't want to, you don't want to. Yeah, there's also a link to the merch shop in case you want to browse there. And then that is going to be it for today's video. I'm going to bake my birthday cake. It is a cake the Dutch way, so not the American cake as in round. No, I think that you would kind of call our types of cake bread, which is weird because a banana bread is still a cake, but that's Dutch. So I'm basically going to bake a cake, a Dutch cake. What's it called? A carrot and walnut, vegan, of course, in a loaf tin. That's how we bake our cakes. So, yeah, that's what I'm going to make. Because it's very, very tasty. And then I'm also going to kind of minimally edit the video, probably, and then throw it online. So you can watch me in all my glory. If you've made it this far, leave me a birthday cake or a birthday emoji. Yes, thank you so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. But I won't be online a lot today. So just just so that you know. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. Mine does if I do this. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.